Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm looking at dividing polynomials in this video. This is saying that 45x to the fourth minus 20x squared plus 30x minus 35 is being divided by negative 5x. And so that could have been written, same problem, could have been written this way. So you'll see sometimes it's written this way as a fraction, and sometimes it's written this way as an older division problem. But what that means is that every term is divided by the term in the denominator. So I'm going to actually have four different problems to simplify here. And so when I set that up, it looks like this. 45x to the fourth over negative 5x, negative 20x squared over negative 5x, positive 30x over negative 5x, negative 35 over negative 5x, and then I'm going to simplify each part. 45 divided by negative 5 is negative 9. I have four x's on the top and only one on the bottom. That's going to leave x to the third. A negative times a negative, or divided by a negative, is a positive. 20 divided by 5 is 4. I have one extra x on top. 30 divided by negative 5 is negative 6. My x's are going to cancel out completely. And then here I have two negatives. When divided with two negatives, I get a positive. And I can see that I have 35 divided by 5, which is 7, but I can also see that there's an x in the denominator that's not going away. So I end up with 7 over x. So be prepared to have some fractions in your problem. If you have more x's on the bottom, that's where they're going to be in the final answer. Or I'll be prepared to have a number down there. It doesn't matter. When you simplify, you're just simplifying. So if I had something like 5 over 30, I would say that that's 1 over 6, right? We just simplify just like we would any other fractions in our life. Okay, the other thing in this one is, given a equation, can you say what the domain is for this equation? And what I want you to remember about rational equations is that none of the denominators can equal 0. If you have a denominator that equals 0, then it's undefined. So we have to figure out what would cause that to happen. So we're going to set our denominators equal to 0 and solve. You can see that dividing both sides by 2 here would just be 0. So x can't be 0, or that would be undefined. This one, if I subtract 2 and divide by 3, I get x is negative 2/3. So that can't be negative 2/3, or else I'd get a 0. And this one, if I add 3 and divide by 5, I get x equals 3/5. So these are the three values that I can't let my domain be. It could be anything else in the universe, but it can't be those three values. So I would state my answer, the set of all x, such that x does not equal 0, or negative 2/3, or 3/5. The order here is not important. Those three values don't have to be in any particular order. I should have put negative to positive, I guess. But the idea is that we can't allow, if we find an answer and it's one of these, we can't use it, because we can't use something that causes the denominator to be 0. All right, have a fantastic day.